In the description of intonation, we have got two main methods, two main ways to explain about intonation. One is the traditional method, like when we are showing those curves, okay? Like the rising pitch, the rising intonation, and then the falling one, okay? And when it is, you know, static. Yeah, but this is not the only way. There is one more way, and that's a framework which is called TOBI, basically. And that TOBI is the tone and break indices. It's given in the fifth chapter of your book by Lederfogel and Johnson. And that's an important way to explain intonation, right? And rather the more effective way, because we are analyzing intonation within speech, within different varieties, or within language spoken by different people, within different circumstances, within different environments, using the same framework. And this framework can give us, you know, quite useful ways to not only understand the intonational patterns, but we can also describe those intonational patterns in terms of, you know, the breaks and indices. So that's an important way for describing the intonation. And the way is the same, because we are to determine where is the pitch going up, like the high pitch, and then when it is coming down, then we are calling it the low pitch. And similarly, those patterns are analyzed. And we are, again, concerned with the changes of pitch, like the pitch variation, because ultimately, the intonation is the variation of pitch at sentence level, right? And we are, like traditionally, we are concerned with just those accents and those pitches, right? Those prominent peaks in order to describe and also to show those accent boundary, right? So our focus is on three things within an intonational phrase. Like one, that where is the pitch accent, okay? Or the peak, all right? The phrase accent, basically. Like when the phrase is ending, what's the tendency at the end, right? And then what is happening at the boundary, right? So these three things are described about an intonational phrase. And this is the, you know, the table through which the intonation is, you know, described. If you can just see that in the first of the column, this one, because there is a possibility of six types of optional pronuclear, because the nuclear pitch is the pitch accent, okay? The, you know, the tonic accent, right? So the tonic accent on the basis of which you would finally describe the tone, right? That's given here. But before that, if there is in the intonational phrase some additional, which is optional, basically, optional information given, you can talk about them, right? And if there is any stressed syllable, right? And you just want to discuss that this is stressed, right? Or is it high or low? Or if that's, you know, the low, you know, a tone followed by the stressed high, you know, tone, or there is a low tone where an adjacent, you know, syllable is the high one, right? And then there is a downstep, a possibility of the high tone, right? Along with high, right? And then in the second column, that's an important point. Because the first column is optional. You can give this information or not. But these three columns are really important, the second, third, and fourth one. Because we are required for about every intonational phrase to talk about the tonic accent. Okay, so what's the final? And within this framework, the name is nuclear pitch accent, right? So what's the basic tonic accent of the phrase, right? So high, low, high, preceded by low, low followed by high, high along with high, right? And then downstepped high, right? And when, of course, we are required to mention the tonic accent, but then if there is any point, like in the sentence that we know the new mayor, so we know the new mayor, because since the new is the new knowledge given, right? So that is the tonic accent, the new one. But after that new, since new is not the final accent, there is a possibility that what is followed. So what's the, you know, the phrase accent at the end, right? So what happens after that nuclear pitch accent, right? So it gives us the idea of the remaining part of the phrase, which is short through this phrase accent. And the phrase accent may be either low or high because it's ending. So it may be mentioned like falling or rising. And then what's the boundary of the tone, right? So what is the end of the tone? Is it going up or is it coming down or is it like, what's the possibility, right? So H, like the high, and L, low. So these are two possibilities for showing the boundary tone. And this framework is really important. We will talk about the application of this framework on some of the sentences given in the book, and we would describe them and explain them.